Hey, this is Sonny from Jax. Welcome back. This is our third video in this series. The third shipment for CBCS we got back from the Memphis Comic Con and Expo. With me, I have my buddy Brian Jormungandr Lohmann. Brian Jormungandr Lohmann.
Yar.
So we're going to open this box up here and see what we got. Now, this is probably not going to be as many as the first batch. The first batch we did was the biggest batch of like 30. The second batch we did was magazines, so we only had about, I don't know, like a dozen maybe. Again, the big guys on this show were Kevin Eastman, Garth Ennis, Scott Innes, stuff like that. You know, there weren't any big celebrities in this thing, so we didn't really worry about that too much. We're gonna try to get our thing done here. All right, hold on to that box a second. Alright, you see, coming straight out of the box, still wrapped up, so ain't nobody tampering with nothing. That's how it comes. That's how we got them. So, let me see that real quick. I'm going to start cutting out here. Like I said, Memphis Comic Con Expo, not a bad show to do. The people that run it are really friendly, really nice. They got it down pat. If you're a vendor or an artist, it's a pretty good deal. I mean, they got everything organized. They have your table names on there, and everything's marked off on tape, and the tables are situated. They give you, you know, sometimes they give you an extra chair, too, if you need it. So, a lot of people, I go in there because it's more down-to-earth. The line, initially in the morning, is okay. It doesn't take too long to get through, but the wait's not very long, so you're gonna run through the lines fairly quickly. You don't have to stay outside no hour or two trying to get in. It's not that kind of convention. The most you're gonna wait is a few minutes on the outside in the morning, and then it'll stream in as we go. Since it's an artist show and writer show, most of those guys will be there at 9 o'clock or 9:30 when it opens up. Unlike the celebrities, sometimes those little guys don't come in when you do a show till like 11, 12, 1, you know. So they come in when they want to, because that's what they are, the celebrities, do what they want, I guess. But the artists and writers and the fan-based stuff, the comic books, they're more tuned to the attendees, and they'll try to meet and greet all the attendees they can. So they don't waste any time drinking 17 Starbucks. All right. So Brian, what's your favorite convention this year?
Oh man, that's a tough one. I think the Mississippi Comic Con I think was my favorite because I got to meet Christopher Lloyd. Man, Memphis, like I'm kind of disappointed I didn't go.
Yeah, it was nice. The best part was the food.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had really good dinners there. You know what I'm saying? Really good dinners. Memphis has a lot of stuff to eat, a lot of different resources to eat. But let's get on to this one here.
Yeah, man.
Let's talk about some more key issues. The last two sets we did were mostly signed Ennis, Garth Ennis, and Eastman stuff. This is more key issues. So here we go. The first one is Spider-Man number 344. Why is this part important?
I'm thinking Carnage, man.
Kind of. This is the first appearance of Cletus Kasady, the serial killer, who becomes Carnage later. But it's important that he makes an appearance because Cletus Kasady becomes Carnage. Right? This is it. This is the issue. So 9.0, first appearance of Cletus Kasady. First full appearance of Elias Wortham as Cardiac, that's the guy in front, it doesn't mean nothing. But Cletus Kasady is the most important thing there. Alright, here we go. We got a first appearance of Jason Todd as the Red Hood.
Oh wow.
9.2. No autograph, no nothing, just a key issue. First appearance of the Red Hood, Jason Todd. You know what that is?
Yeah.
Alright. Now we got some signed stuff from the boys. I got a 9.6 boys number 7, a 9.8 boys number 7, 9-8, boys number 7. 9-6, boys number 7. Another 9-6, boys number 7. Another 9-8, boys number 7. Another 9-8, boys number 7. And then I get this lowly 8-5 out of the blue. This is your 8-5.
Oh, right? Yeah, there we
this
go.
This is yours.
That's, yeah.
The 3 9.8s, those are mine. These okay. are yours. But either way, the customers are probably pretty happy with that last batch, all the 9s. And then, of course, you know, obviously they're going to be a little upset with 8-5, you know what I'm saying? But they can all be 9.0s.
There are some people that this is in their price range, and they, you know.
All right, so someone brought in Monsters Unleashed number 12. It's got a Moon Girl Devil Dinosaur appearance, 9.6. All right, I'm not sure why this is graded, but, you know, I don't argue with my customers. If you want them getting graded, we'll set them off for you. Why would they get Monsters Unleashed graded?
I have no idea.
It's got Moon Girl and Devil Dinosaur cover appearance. Oh, this is the last issue.
Oh.
Yeah, it's issue number 12. I guess it's the last issue, yeah. I don't know if they give you any notice, but it's the last issue. All right, let's see what we got here. We got a Kevin Eastman autograph. Got one of them. It's Teen Mutant Ninja Turtles annual number 2023. All right, 9.6, signed by Kevin Eastman. This is the Jetpack Comics and Games exclusive. It's also sponsored by Forbidden Planet. I'm not supportive of them guys. I'm just telling you where it came from, okay? So this is a, I guess con / convention exclusive, signed by Kevin Eastman, 9.6. All right, this is the signed by Kevin Eastman and Tessa Rose. This is the Biloxi Anime Comic Expo convention exclusive. Biloxi Comic Expo exclusive right here. It says on top, it says BA and CE 2020 exclusive variant. That's Biloxi Anime and Comic Expo.
That's cool.
Yes. Here's another one at 9.4. 9.4.
Oh, that's cool. You notice in the barcode where it says covered by Tessa Rose? That's
yeah, covered by Tessa Rose. IDW has a good job about promoting their artists. You know, giving credit for everything. All right, so we have a Kevin Eastman autograph here. This is the last run in last year's Lost Days special, no number. Signed by Kevin Eastman, 9.8. There we go. Lost Days special, 9.8. Signed by Kevin Eastman. All right, what else we got here? We have a last run in last year's variant cover, signed by Kevin Eastman, 9.8. Look at that, 9.8. Somebody could be happy with that one. But we have a last year's another variant cover, 9.6. 9.6, not too bad, not too shabby. Not for being signed.
It's like they're wraparound covers, yeah.
Yes, and then we have a last year's number 4, signed by Kevin Eastman, 9.8. Doing good signing, Kevin, without tearing the books up. Good job. Good job signing them. All right, then we have last lost drawn in number 5, signed by Kevin Eastman, 9.8. Let me tell you something, Brian. All right. A lot of people like getting sketches with the Kevin Eastman autograph, but I watch it. Sometimes when he's in a hurry and he has like 200 people online, he rushes through the sketches. So sometimes you won't get a 9.8, but if he just autographs it at his leisure, right? Mm-hmm. You're more likely to attain the 9.8, so the higher grades when he does that. You notice how many 9.8s we got, but they're autographed only, no sketches? I found that out by watching him doing conventions. Now, he can obviously do a sketch and an autograph and still get a 9.8. I'm not saying you can't get one. I'm just saying that you're more likely to get a 9.8 if he just signs it and doesn't sketch it.
Yeah.
Because you're doing more work, your hand's going to be on the comic book more, you're doing more stretchy stuff, you can flick your wrist or whatever it is and damage the book, or you can just make extra marks, whatever it may be, you think? But that's just a word of wisdom. You can do what you want. 9.6, signed by Kevin Eastman, Tessa Rose. This is a Tessa Rose cover for this book. She's the cover artist. 9.6, signed by both of them. Here is a 9.8. Woo! This is a 9.8 signed by Kevin Eastman and verified signature of the cover artist, which is Matt Weldon. So 9.8 Matt Weldon, Kevin Eastman double signature. Hard to get. Two different times, two different locations.
That's a cool wraparound cover too.
Right, here's another 9.8. Again, it's a sketch with Matt Weldon down the bottom and autograph of Eastman on top. All right, let's see what else we got here. A few more books in the stack. All right, we have a Ninja Turtles number 140. I don't know. It's a cover swipe of number one. You know what cover swipe is? It's like an homage cover. So it's 9.4 signed by Kevin Eastman. There you go. Got a couple more in here. Here's Turtles number 141 signed by Kevin Eastman. Still in cover?
Oh, yeah.
Like Godzilla almost. All right, so a 141 signed by Kevin Eastman, 9.6. Let's see what we got here. A couple more to go. All right, I have Janika number one signed by Kevin Eastman. This, in fact, is a Matt Weldon cover. I don't know why he didn't sign it. Maybe it's one that we got from him that he didn't sign, so we had a chance to get 9.8. Again, when it's only one autograph versus two, there's a greater chance of getting a 9.8 versus a 9.6 or 9.4. So the only person that signed it was Kevin Eastman, not the cover artist at this time, so we still got 9.8 out of it, which I'm happy with.
Yeah.
So I tell people, the more people have touched his hands on it, the more likely it's not going to get a 9.8. All right, so I got a few more to go. I got this signed Eastman Armageddon game, Ninja Turtles, 8.5. Again, I think when I looked at this book, I didn't think it was going to break a 9 because it had some, I think a line break somewhere. Let me look real quick. Maybe I see it. Oh, see the back corner, how that corner's soft?
Oh, yeah.
See right there, that little corner edge? So the back corners, you can't see it there, but I can blow up later. But these two back corners here are a little soft to me. They're a little worn out a little, like, you know, it has some back rub on the board or something like that. And that's probably why I didn't think it was going to get a point past the 9.0. So 8.5 is a good job for that book. All right, so we have another cover of the Ninja Turtles Last Ronin and Lost Years number one, signed by Kevin Eastman, 9.6. There you go. And the last book in the series that we got back is, again, a Last Ronin, Lost Years, Lost Day special, no number, signed by Kevin Eastman also, 9.6. So we got a lot of high grades on Eastman. We went up there and, you know, people pick and chose the best books they could find to give him to sign. And you could tell that we only had, like, I think maybe two below 9.0. The rest are like high nines, 9.4s, 9.6, 9.8s. So when you get stuff signed by people, please take your time, if you want a good grade, to pick the best book. It doesn't really matter what book it is, if you're going to get an autograph anyway, because the autograph itself will increase the value of the book, right?
Yeah.
A little bit. But if you have, like, a really good artist signature, like on, say, Spider-Man 300, Spider-Man 300 at 9.8 is still a grand or more, right? So the autograph's only going to kick it, like, $50. So it's going to go $1,050 instead of $1,000. No big deal, right? But if a smaller book that's, like, $10 or $20 has a $50 autograph on it, then they'll kick it to $100. See? So exponentially, the better the book, the less likely I would get it autographed.
Yeah.
The more average the book, that's the more I like it autographed. But the average books will retain a higher grade value because they're not handled as much or read as much. That makes sense?
Yeah.
All right, well, good luck to you out there in comic book collecting land. Hopefully we try to help you get your grades higher. Hope you find some people you like, getting some signed, artists, writers, inkers, panelists, whatever you might do. But if you have any questions, hit me down below, ask me a question, I'll answer as soon as I get to it. Or you can message me on Facebook or Instagram. We're all here. So till next time, this is Sonny from Jax and my buddy Brian Yorman Gunder Lohman.